Hello and welcome to my video tutorials. In this video I'm going to apply wash technique and only use black color in order to receive a final black and white study showing the tonal relationship between objects of the still life. But what is wash? A wash is a term for a visual arts technique resulting in a semi-transparent layer of color. It is a combination of diluted ink or watercolor paint with drawing. For this technique, only one or two colors of wash are used. If more colors are used, the final picture is likely to be classified as a full watercolor painting. I start with identifying a general composition and then constructing each object of the still life, making a preliminary pencil drawing before applying colors. I identify the general layout of the composition to see if it's more a landscape or a portrait layout. Then I measure the objects themselves using the stretched arm only. As if your arm is not straight, you won't get the correct proportional measurements. I start with applying the axes, the middle one to keep the tankard symmetrical and the top and bottom ones for each ellipse for the upper and lower open parts of this object. Then I correct the ellipses and connect them with straight lines to shape up the tankard. I always try to apply as few pencil lines as possible, making them hardly visible before I begin applying colors. Only black one in this case. One should keep only traces of outlines on the paper shaping up the objects with the colors where the preliminary drawing is only a suggestion of the shape of an object. Also you can check with the edges of the paper to see if the axes are straight and perpendicular to the horizontal bottom line of the paper. Also carefully study the character, the exact shape of the objects of the still life. Looking at the still life, always identify the borders between the horizontal and vertical surfaces, where they meet and all the angles they create. It also depends on your position towards the entire still life. You can stand straight in front of it, so the horizontal lines of the surface will be parallel to you, but if you look at your still life from an angle, it will create some perspective, so the lines of horizontal surface won't be parallel to you, but will create some movement meeting with the vertical surface lines in a perspective view. This is the example of my current still life as I'm standing with an angle towards it. After you've finished with the pencil drawing of your composition, gently erase the lines, leaving only traces of pencil. Never apply any pressure on watercolor paper while erasing the pencil lines, as it might damage the surface of the paper and you won't be able to achieve the desired freshness of your painting. Before applying any colors, always identify the lighter and darker parts of your still life. Once you are identifying the darkest parts, you can be brave and instead of building the darkest part through thinner layers, you can load your brush with more saturated color, hence less dissolved, and start with dark tones straight away. Just a reminder, watercolor fades with drying, keep this in mind, and whenever you need to create really deep tone effect, apply the denser color straight away, avoiding applying too many layers, jeopardizing the freshness of your entire final work. And now, enjoy the rest of the video. If you have any questions, please contact me on Nadine at nadinegallery.co.uk. Thank you.